Well, hello, visitors to and denizens of the YouTubeverse. I'm John, your social hermit in the woods. And in this video, I wanted to talk about something simple you could do if you're into ham radio and you wanted to have a light implementation of something similar to what's called a ham clock, but you wanted to be able to run this in Windows. There is a set of applications going around, very popular with a lot of ham radio users on the internet. It's a device called, or a set of software called, usually HamClock. And this displays a bunch of really useful information for your station. Usually there's something like a gray line map of the world, sort of like a geochron, except a digital version thereof. And maybe some satellite information if you're into that, and a UTC clock, and a bunch of other interesting things. These ham clock installations run under Linux, and only Linux. And that leaves you with a lot of things you can do. You could run that on a Raspberry Pi. You can get pre-made systems. There's a company called... Innovato, I think they're called. They make something called the Quadra, which is this little $35 preloaded computer, and that's basically what it's designed to do, and you can do some other stuff on it. Really cute, really nice. I saw these online and said, wow, that would be kind of neat if I could do that. I thought these looked pretty nice, but I have a limited amount of desk space. Usually I don't even have this side laptop here. I'm running some JS8 with a QRP radio right now. So usually I just have this old Windows 7 computer here. Now, you can run HamClock in Linux in a headless mode and then see that on other non-Linux computers, which would be one solution. But it struck me that for my needs, what I wanted was a geochron-style gray line world map. I also wanted to see where my signals were getting out to, so something like what you would see with Reverse Beacon Network for CW or PSK Reporter, which does CW and digital modes and shows you where your signal's getting out, or you can look at NCDXF signal propagation. I wanted to have a solar terrestrial indices information, and I wanted a UTC clock, just a couple of things. If you're as old as I am, you'll remember the dawn of the popular internet age. And it included browsers such as the aptly named Mosaic from NCSA, National Center for Supercomputing Applications. Mosaic was a brilliant name for it because, in particular, what the early web was the first thing to do was to be able to pull disparate bits of information from different places across the web and then format them and put them all together on a single web page. And it suddenly struck me everything I wanted for a ham clock type application was already out there somewhere on the web. It was freely available. And I didn't need to go to Linux to do this. I could actually do something really simple right in an old Windows 7 system and do that. And so what I did, it's just a very simple little bit of code. I pull the three things I want. I use PSK Reporter, and it's preset to automatically use my call sign and 1 hour, the settings that I like. It's centered where I like it. It's got the zoom factor I like by default. I have a UTC clock, and I have some solar terrestrial data, and these all show up. The PSK Reporter type stuff updates every 5 minutes, which is what it automatically does. And it takes up about a quarter of my screen. It provides what I want. And this is really simple. So in order to do this, I wrote three very simple little pieces of HTML code. One is a general document, which provides the overall structure. Now, I was a bad HTML coder. I used frames here. Frames are deprecated. You're supposed to use something called an iframe now. But I'm using this on an older computer. It supports frames, and I had used them before, and so I was just trying to do this in an hour over coffee in the morning. So this is a really simple HTML project. If you have any experience at all with HTML coding, you can make something like this yourself, and then you don't need a whole separate computer to run this for you. If you think this is cool and you would like to run it on your Windows system and you don't want to learn how to do HTML coding, feel free to drop me an email. It's right there in the YouTube contact information and give me your call sign. It takes me about 30 seconds to customize one of these to your call sign. And what you do is you end up with three HTML files. You put those in a single folder anywhere on your system. It is operating system agnostic. It doesn't care what computer, what system you're running. And then one of those, one that's labeled as HamDash, you start that. It calls the other two little bits of code to populate a couple of the other frames, and you get this handy little thing that comes up. So, hopefully that might be helpful to some of you. I kind of thought this was just something that I would be interested in, but I had a few other people who saw this and were interested and asked for copies, and I thought, well, maybe I would share it with those of you out there who might be interested. You can either make yourself a copy, or you can get in touch with me. If you don't want to learn HTML coding, drop me an email via the YouTube channel. Give me your call sign. And it takes a matter of a few seconds to customize one of these to where it's your call sign that shows up and your call sign that's embedded in PSK Reporter. And I can email it back to you. You can then open it up and modify it as you see fit. It's really only a very few lines of code, and most of it's pretty much self-explanatory. I hope that was somewhat helpful and interesting, and maybe some of you will get some use out of that. Until next time, this is John, your social hermit in the woods, saying goodbye.